In part 2 of our lesson on vectors, you will learn how to find the sum of two vectors. Now remember that a vector has both magnitude and direction, so we have to figure out a way to add something that has both size and direction. And think about, what does it mean to add something that has direction? We are going to learn two methods to accomplish this. The first method for adding two vectors is accomplished by placing the vectors head to tail. The second method accomplishes adding the two vectors by making a parallelogram. So let's see how these two methods work. In this example, we have to draw vector C so that it is equal to vector A plus vector B. So let's look at our two methods. We'll start by using method 1. The first step says to draw vector A. So here we have our vector A, so we want to make a vector A that looks just like that vector A. So we give ourselves our initial point, and then we draw a vector that's equal in length and going in the same direction as vector A. The second step says we draw vector B by placing the initial point of vector B at the terminal point of vector A. So here's our vector B, so imagine that we lift it up and we're going to place it over here at the terminal point of vector A. So there's vector B, and here's the terminal point. Now the last step says that the resultant vector C extends from the initial point of vector A to the terminal point of vector B. So that means that vector C goes here. Starting from the initial point of vector A and going directly to the terminal point of vector B. And so this vector C represents the sum of vector A plus vector B. It's kind of like taking a shortcut. So instead of having to walk along vector A and then turning and walking along vector B, you could start here and walk directly along vector C. Now let's do this addition using method 2, where we are making a parallelogram. So the first step says to draw vector A and vector B with their initial points together. So let's start by making a point that will be the initial point of both vector A and vector B. So now we'll get vector A in our picture. And we will now draw vector B starting from that same initial point. The next step says consider vector A and vector B as the adjacent sides of a parallelogram and draw the rest of the parallelogram. So we're going to use dotted lines here. We know that the sides that are opposite each other in a parallelogram are going to be parallel, so we try to draw a dotted line that is parallel to vector A and the same length. And then we do the same thing over here. We want to draw a dotted line that is parallel to vector B and the same length. So now we have created a parallelogram. In the last step, it says that the resultant, vector C, is the diagonal of the parallelogram extending from the joined initial points. So every parallelogram has two diagonals. We have this diagonal here, and we have this diagonal here. And the directions say to use the diagonal that starts from their joined initial points. So then C will be this vector. And it's pretty easy to see that whether we accomplish the addition of the vectors by placing them head to tail here, or by creating the parallelogram, we're getting the same vector C as our solution. In this example, we have to draw vector D so that it is equal to vector A minus vector B. Well, we don't have any methods for subtracting vectors, but we do have a method for adding vectors, so we can think of this as vector A plus the opposite of vector B, and then we can use the two methods that we just learned. Now, in order to add vector A plus the opposite of vector B, first we need a picture of the opposite of vector B. Now, remember the definition that you just learned. Opposite vectors have the same magnitude, but opposite direction. So if this is vector B, then we know that the opposite of vector B is going to have the same length, but just go in the opposite direction. So there is the vector that is opposite of vector B, and now we can use our two methods to add those two vectors together. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. So in the first method, we know that we'll need to give ourselves a starting point. So there's the initial point for the first vector. And the first step says to draw vector A. So we will draw a vector going in the same direction and with the same length as vector A. Now the second step tells us to start at the terminal point of A and let that become the initial point of our opposite of B and draw that vector. So now we will start here and we will draw the opposite of B starting from there. Here's the terminal point of the opposite of B. In the last step, it says that the resultant, in our case, vector D this time, extends from the initial point of the first vector to the terminal point of the second vector. So that means vector D goes from here to here. Now let's try it. using the second method. We know we have to draw the two vectors with their initial points together. So once again, we'll make a point here to use as our initial point. And we need to draw in vector A. As well as vector negative B. And this time we have their initial points together. The second step tells us to consider these as the adjacent sides of a parallelogram and to draw the rest of the parallelogram. So we can use dotted lines. We know we want to make this side the same length and the same direction as the opposite of B. And this side needs to be parallel and equal in length to A. Finally, the resultant will be the diagonal of the parallelogram that starts from that same initial point. So we know that D will be this diagonal. And once again, we can see that whether we use the head-to-tail method or we use the parallelogram method, vector D is the same magnitude and direction in each case.